Hello students, welcome to my zoology class. This is Akmal Hussain, lecturer biology, Square High School and College. Now I am going to take a zoology class of standard 10, chapter 5, digestive system. Today's topic is digestive glands. Last class we have discussed about alimentary canal or digestive canals. Today we have to discuss about digestive glands. What is digestive glands? The glands whose secretion takes part in the digestion of food are called digestive glands. That means the glands whose secretion is connected with our digestive canal or alimentary canal and helps in digestion is called digestive glands. Types of digestive glands. There are 5 types of digestive glands are there. Number 1, salivary glands. Number 2, liver. Number 3, gastric glands. Number 4, pancreas. Number 5, intestinal glands. Salivary glands. Follow the picture. There are 3 types of salivary glands: parotid gland, sublingual glands, and submandibular glands. Number of parotid gland 2, number of sublingual 2, and number of submandibular 2. That means 3 pair of salivary glands are located around our buccal cavity or mouth cavity. Secretion. Secretes saliva, which contains water and ghrelin. Functions of salivary glands. You know, salivary glands secretes saliva, which contains most of the part is water. Water makes our food slippery, that we may swallow it easily, as well as ghrelin, which is the another part of saliva, helps to digest the simple form of carbohydrate and convert it into simple form of carbohydrate. Gastric glands. Inner layer of stomach carries huge amount of tiny glands, which is called gastric glands. Actually, the inner layer of stomach carries huge amount of gastric glands. Secretion, gastric juice, which contains gastrin, hydrochloric acid, pepsinogen, etc. Function of gastric glands. Gastric gland secretes gastric juice, especially gastrin help in digestion. Hydrochloric acid helps to kill the microorganism if entered into stomach, as well as it helps to break down the food particles into finest form, as well as active the pepsinogen into pepsin. Pepsin can help to digest the protein type of food. Liver. You know, liver is the largest gland of our body. The liver is situated just below the diaphragm on the right side of the stomach. It is deep brown in color. The right lobe is larger than the left. The liver consists of 4 incomplete lobes. Each lobe consists of lobules. Each lobule contains numerous cells, which is called hepatic cell. These cells produces bile. Bile is alkaline in nature. Different types of biochemical reactions take place in liver. So it is also called the organic laboratory of animal body. It secretes bile. Bile contains water, bile salt, cholesterol and mineral salt. This triangular shaped organ, which is located the right side of our abdomen just beneath the diaphragm, is liver. Liver secretes bile, and bile is stored in a sac named gallbladder, and bile from gallbladder it by the help of common duct or common bile duct entered into duodenum and help to digest the different types of food. Functions of liver. Number one, liver produces bile. Number two, it stores excessive glucose as glycogen. Number three, it neutralizes the acidic chyme and creates alkaline medium. It breaks fat or oil droplets into mute droplets. Excessive amino acids are taken to liver. Various chemical reactions are taken part in it. Pancreas. The pancreas is an important mixed gland located obliquely at the back of the stomach. Actually, it is located our abdominal cavity, right left side of our abdominal cavity, just beneath the diaphragm. That means the pancreas location is just opposite of our liver. The pancreas secretes digestive juice as well as hormones and enzymes. Secretes hormones, insulin, glucagon. Pancreatic juice consists of enzymes, amylase, lipase and trypsin. Follow here. Pancreas called mixed gland. Why it is called mixed gland? Because it secretes at a time hormone and enzymes. It secretes hormones and enzyme at a time. That's why this organ or this gland is called mixed gland. Functions of pancreas. Pancreatic juice neutralizes the acidity of chyme, takes part in digestion. Protein are converted into amino acid with trypsin. Carbohydrate are converted into glucose with amylase. Fats are converted into fatty acid with lipase. Controls body temperature. Controls glucose level in blood. These are the important functions of pancreas. Intestinal glands. The inner wall of intestine carries huge amount of small glands, which is called intestinal glands. It may be small intestinal glands or large intestinal glands. Secretion, intestinal juice. Function of intestinal juice. Follow the picture. This is the villi, which is present the inner wall of duodenum. It helps to absorb the digested food. Now, functions of intestinal glands. Number one, intestinal juice neutralize hydrochloric acid coming from stomach, helps in digestion, helps in absorption. Helps in digestion means if undigested part or if the chyme, that means the liquid semi digested part which is comes from which is came from stomach is called chyme. This chyme mixed with the bile and the pancreatic juice, amylase, lipase, trypsin, chymotrypsin, etc. And finally, they converted into simple and absorbable form. Thus, helps in digestion as well as helps in absorption. We have seen the picture of villi. Villi is the special type of gland which present in duodenum and helps to absorb the digested food. Thank you.